Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, let's discuss some of the technologies which are used in the WLAN, that is the wireless local area networks. So I have considered three major widely used technologies which are there in the WLAN. So we have the very first one is the infrared rays or the IR. So this you can see in most of the devices, domestic devices, like in remote for television systems and all. So this is nothing but a kind of thermal energy in which you see the objects in different forms or in different colors, like you have red, green, blue and yellow kind of thing. So that's kind of thermal energy, just you can see the different kind of objects in a different perspective. So it is an invisible radiant energy with larger or longer wavelength. So it has wavelength much larger as compared to the visible light. So you can see in the frequency spectrum where this infrared rays actually falls. And this IR requires a line of sight for transmission. Now, line of sight means the data transfer is done if and only if the receiving and the sending stations, both these stations which are there, are visible to each other without any obstruction. Means if there is some station one standing here and if station two is here, then they should be seeing each other. Means station or the receiving station should see the transmitting and the transmitting should see the sending one, and so majorly there should not be any obstruction between these two. So in short, infrared rays is a short range technology which cannot penetrate through any solid objects like buildings. So it's not like the Wi-Fi signals or the Wi-Fi radiations which you have, which can pass through different objects like solid objects, bricks or even cements. But these are very sensitive, or these rays are very just sensitive, where it finds any obstructions, it cannot just pass through the other end. So it's limited to the indoor use, where you have operating frequencies in the inside systems in a laboratory. Next, we have the ultra high frequency UHF, also called as the narrow band radios. So these are the radio frequency signals with having frequency ranges of 12.5 to 25 kilohertz. And so there is one requirement that it requires 1 to 2 watts for power level range. Means its operating frequency is within this 1 to 2 watts of power range. So the transmission is done majorly with these systems utilizing 800 megahertz. And so different systems or different devices which are there in the WLANs have certain kinds of frequency ranges labeled in them. And so devices having with frequencies 800 megahertz or near to that can only transmit with UHF. And so the frequency range for UHF is between 430 to 470 megahertz. And so you just divide this frequency spectrum into two parts, that is lower portion and upper portion. So the frequency range of 430 to 450 megahertz is called as the lower portion, and so it is termed as the unprotected band or the unprotected portion. And so this part is unlicensed band, or it falls under this category. And so utilizing this does not require any RF, special RF licenses not required. Whereas you have the upper portion or the higher portion of 450 to 470 megahertz, which is the protected band, and you require certain kind of license in order to use these frequencies. Next, we have the third type of technology, that you have the spread spectrum radios. So spread spectrum we already saw in the beginning of this tutorial, like we have the direct sequence spread spectrum and frequency hopping spectrum. So those two technologies are there basically. So it is just used to spread the incoming signal into a much larger area for having a larger bandwidth. So signal is made to spread in a wider bandwidth. And so you have two different technologies. You have the direct sequence spread spectrum DSSS and you have frequency hopping spread spectrum FHSS. So DSSS employs radio transmission which is done on multiple radio channels, and it does so by using a coding technique. So some kind of coding or chipping sequence is there in order to transmit the signal into much larger wavelength or into a much larger geographical area. And so a multiple of different wavelengths is just used to multiply the other signals. And so frequency is altered with respect to coding and in order to extend or improve the bandwidth. So this frequency is just improved using this coding technique, where you just multiply with all the incoming signals and thereby you just have the extended bandwidth. Next, we have the frequency hopping spread spectrum FHSS. So in this, you consider a hopping sequence which is used for synchronizing the receiver. Means the setup which FHSS has is it's very costly, and so you need to have the synchronization between the sender and the receiver. So that hopping sequence is just inputted to the receiver in order to synchronize all the incoming signals, and the signal is extended over a wider bandwidth due to the hopping sequence. So hopping sequence is the key factor, whereas in DSS we have the coding technique, here we have the hopping sequence. And so in this, when you just transmit the signal and when you get the output, the average output power is much reduced when you see from the incoming signal. So well, that was all regarding the different type of technologies which are used in WLAN. So hope you guys enjoyed this. If you got educated watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider to subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.